saying, come through, you know. You know, I got, you know, getting, you know, you never know what can happen, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
You know, you might get a little physical, you know, I think I may make that move, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's what you want.
Just like my ex-girlfriend. She died last week. She didn't die, but you look just like her. We can do like a double date or something crazy like that. My treat.
Okay.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? How you doing? Welcome back to another slightly less scintillating episode of G-Play69 as I am fighting off a really bad infection. Thought I was just, anybody's been following the stream here. I've been feeling a little run down and not my usual self here on stream. Not quite as high energy as usual, and I thought I was just fighting off a cold. Oh, and then I was actually after my stream last night. I was going to bed and I realized, Jesus, I got all these weird lumps in the side of my neck. I'm like, that's not good. So off to the doctor we went, and it turns out I have a pretty serious infection. No idea how the fuck I got that. I guess just burning the candles at both ends and not getting enough sleep and all that. And so the doctor's got me on a hell of an antibiotic, which is kicking my ass. And I'm like, I don't feel too bad, but I'm fucking cold. I got like the cold, like one minute I'm sweating and the next minute I'm freezing cold and all that kind of shit, right? So it may be a little bit of a quiet stream, but I figure, you know, I can't sleep anymore. I did manage to get some rest, but I'm, you know, a few hours till the kid gets up and I can't get back to bed. So let's tool around in space, have a relaxing little space adventure. That sounds just about perfect right now. So yes, I appreciate you guys joining me, and just give me a few minutes here, and I'll be ready to go. I should mention too, we got a Twitch payout, so we've dumped that straight into the kitty there. So we're getting there, folks. That stream dream is coming alive. Once again, I'd really like to thank everybody who's been supportive. You know, I've tried to throw, you know, probably the majority, a good $250-$300 of that is straight out of my pocket, to be honest with you. It's me just scraping and screaming, saving, trying to make this happen. But all the rest of that has been you guys and the support I've gotten from the channel and stuff. And I, you know, and honestly, that's making the difference. I wouldn't be able to do it otherwise. So, I really appreciate you guys. And look at that. I thought that was pretty hilarious. It came out to with the 69 cents payout. I was like, oh, isn't life just fitting sometimes? I was like, Twitch, are you playing jokes on me? I thought that was kind of funny. But there you go. All right, a few minutes here. We'll be ready to roll.
Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1. Engage. complete.
It's not rendering properly.
Surface scan complete. Thank you. Frameshift drive charging. Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
shift drive charging. System scan complete. Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging. Thank you. surface scan by 50%.
Hey, Wolfie man, what's cracking? How are you doing, buddy? I'm not good, man. I thought I was just fighting off a cold, but it turns out I've been fighting off a really severe infection, which started to totally kick my ass here in the last day or two. So I am now on a crap load of antibiotics, and I feel like crap. So pardon me if I'm a little quiet, and I've been this whole last week, I've just been really out of it, man, and now I know why. But yeah, I don't feel so good. Yeah, well, the doc said it should be something I can shake off. It's just... Basically, it sounds like my body was trying to fight it off for a good week and a bit, and then failed. And it started to win, and that's when I... Yeah, so... But it sounds like with the antibiotic, I should be able to shake it off here, so... Got that salamander sickness, man. Yeah, I'll be right. It's more just taking the wind out of me, man. I got no energy. I'm so fucking tired. You ever have where you're at that experience where you're like, your fucking hair hurts? You know what I mean? You go to run your hand through your hair and you're like, ow, ow, why does my hair hurt? Like, what the hell is that about? Fuck. So yeah, it's not fun. Everything hurts. Fuck. Yeah, I know. Goddamn space herpes. Ain't that the truth?
Oh my goodness. Thanks for stopping in anyways, buddy.
It's good to see you. Again, I apologize if I don't talk quite as much as usual. I'm just... This thing's all bugging out. Look at this. How am I supposed to... It's not showing me nothing. Like, what the hell? That doesn't help. Stupid thing.
Oh, there it is.
Why is it all bugged out like that? You notice that? Bleep. Like, where does it go? Can't see what I've done. It's supposed to show me, isn't it?
I get it for like a split second there when I first hit the button, and then it disappears. Weird. It's gonna make this a little tricky.
Oh, am I looking at the back of the planet somehow? Hang on a second. Oh, toggle planet side. I didn't know I could do that. Well, that'd be why. Oh, I didn't even know I could do that. What the hell button is that? Ah, there we go. Oh, look at that. Well, that's fucking handy. I wasn't even aware that was a thing you could do. I always just winged it. Is that something new to Odyssey? It must be. I don't remember that. Seriously, come on.
that is that the atmosphere is 100% water? What? Is that normal for, like, ice planets? No. I want to go check this one out. I'm curious about this. This looks weird to me.
Yeah, I guess it's just a little rocky body, but it's just, I'm not used to seeing them with so much atmosphere. For me, it is 4:17 in the morning. I said I crashed pretty early with the little rugrat, and didn't do a stream last night. So, and then I woke up like early, couldn't get back to bed. So, I'll probably crash again at some point here before she wakes up, or I'll just stream till she gets up. Sick or not, I still got this whole fucking zoo I'm living with here that I gotta take care of. Yeah, you betcha, buddy. Just flitting around through space, checking out some planets and systems and stuff, seeing what I can find. I kind of have a little rhythm, a little routine. It's not necessarily the most efficient, but it's fun. It kind of mixes fun and efficiency. Sometimes I get bored of just bouncing from planet to planet. So even if I know, like for example right here, it's almost guaranteed these are going to be geologicals that are on this planet are going to be fumaroles and volcanoes and something else that I've probably already seen. But That's still fun to land every once in a while and check things out, huh? Just to keep it mixed up.
Somewhere in here there's a water giant, which are not, they're not worth a ton, but they're not super common, so grab that. And just basically cherry picking my way across the galaxy, man.
Surface scan by 50%.
Check the geological thing. What are they? Yeah, see, it's always lava spouts, fumaroles, vents. Pretty much always. But, it might be worth checking the view. Let's go take a look.
Flight engaged.
I love how that just sort of pops up like that. So cool. Wow, that's cool. That's a weird terrain, hang on a second. Thank you. It's nothing new. I'm just confirming. This is just Iron Magma stuff. Okay. Yeah, still nothing too fancy down there, but it's worth coming and looking. It's pretty nice view. Interesting terrain. I was hoping I might be able to get a view of that gas giant that was close by this planet, but it doesn't really show up. You know him, man. It's a big part of what I like about exploration. It's kind of through pictures you kind of chronicle your journey along the way, and anything interesting you find, it's, you know, it's fun to share. Cool looking planets and all kinds of stuff, man. Like I said, I love our Discord channel because there's so much interesting. Like, and now we got Zagrammy in there, and he's sharing all kinds of really cool pictures between him and Witchman. You know, some really beautiful sights, man. It's cool. It's fun to get out there and see him yourself, too. What kind of gravity well am I caught in here? What's going on? Is that planet up above me there? Thank you.
surface scan by 50%. Scan complete.
again, I'd like to thank you guys for joining me on this slightly more subdued stream, because I'm sitting here wrapped up in a blanket, and I'm like, I can't, it's like hot and cold sweats back and forth, and it sucks. I've got this stupid infection. I thought I just had a cold, and I thought I was going to be able to shake it off, and then it just, after the stream last night there, I don't even know my stream on Sundays, and then after the stream on Sunday there, I realized something was seriously wrong with me. So yeah, all jacked up on antibiotics, I should be able to shake it off, but just having a nice relaxing flit around space here, see what we can find.
Surface scan by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Alright, I do believe that was everything we were looking for in the system.
Shift drive charging. System scan complete.
Holy crap, those are way up there. What the fuck? Okay, yeah, well, I gotta rip out to the star. That's a bit of a trip, but you know what? For a bunch of... There's 1, 2, 3, 4 undiscovered high metals. Just for those alone, I'll sneak out there. It's a bit of a hike, but what the hell, folks? We've done longer trips than this. Not much longer than 350,000 light seconds, but we have done longer than that. I think I've done about 500. The longest one I ever did. Weirdest thing about this infection is causing them to have all this weird little, like, it's like swollen lymph nodes or whatever the fuck they call them, right? And I guess then they're pressing on, like, the nerves in my neck. So it's making the whole one side of my body, like, buzz, sort of. I don't know how to describe it. It's really uncomfortable. It's kind of like, I don't know, there's no way to get, it's like a constant, almost itchy on a scratch, but there's nothing you can do about it or something. It's not really an itch, it's like a buzzing, but it's like, you know, I don't know, it's fucking annoying. So boy, oh boy, I sure hope these antibiotics work quick and I get back to square here. Ugh. Well, while we're flying out there, I need to give the salamanders a spritz and refill their water a bit, so let's do that. It's so cute, they're both sound asleep, with their heads together sticking out the cave. They're kind of waking up because they hear me, but yeah, see. Oh no, well, I'm not still up, I'm sort of just up. I crashed, no stream last night, and because I had to crash pretty early, man. Turns out I'm not just sick, Wally, I'm fighting off a severe infection in my ear and my lymph nodes. So I'm in rough shape, buddy. I'm on all kinds of antibiotics. And yeah, I just couldn't sleep. Yeah, it sucks.
The worst part about it, dude, is it's causing sort of weird swelling in my neck on the one side, and the swelling is pressing on the nerves. So the whole left side of my body is sort of like buzzing, and it won't stop. It's really fucking annoying. But I couldn't sleep anymore. Fell asleep early with the regret there, and I just couldn't. I couldn't stay down anymore. So I thought, well, I'll get up and stream until she wakes up. Oh, since I didn't get one in last night, what the hell? So, but pardon me, I'm a little more subdued than usual. I'm sitting here all wrapped in a blanket, and it's like hot and cold chills, and I almost everything hurts. My hair hurts, Wally. You ever had that where you run your fingers through your hair and it's like, why is my scalp and my hair hurts? What the hell is that about? Wakey wakey, eggs and bakey, salamanders. A little morning spritz for you. Hey, Stationary Obsessive, how you doing? Stationary, what was that game you were playing? I was watching you play this kind of, it's pretty creepy with the big robots. I didn't catch the name, though. Again, I'm sick. My brain's not working. But hey, shout out to Stationary Obsessive. How are you doing? And pardon me, Stationary, I'm horrendously ill right now, so I'm not sounding so good. There we go. A little spritz and some fresh water for the salamanders, and they're wide awake. Look at that. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. You know, we got... what the hell? We might as well feed them. We got 230-something light seconds to go before we get to where we're going, so... we got a bit of a trip we're trying to do here. Generation Zero. Yeah, that's cool. Those robots are freaky. Biting each other. Miserable creatures. That's why you move them away from each other, because they're always nipping at each other. Hey, come on, you two. Glad you're greedy. Greedies. There, one for you. Don't be greedy. Don't steal it. Let him have it. Don't steal it. I got one for you, too. Of course I do. I always do, you greedy bastards. I've watched them have tug-of-wars over them, where one gets it in the mouth, the other one gets the other one. You know. Oh, of course you're a VIP, come on. I'm not bad. I'm actually not doing too good. The last week or so, I thought I was fighting off a cold, and it turns out it was actually like a really bad infection. So I'm on all kinds of antibiotics and stuff, and I'm feeling kind of like shit, actually. Don't feel like my usual peppy self. But that's all right. Such is life. Otherwise, I'm doing okay. You know. Just one each, you dirty little salamanders. There's a bean. Only one each, you dirty little buggers. I'll get you again later.
Oh my gosh.
Where are we at here? Oop. 100 light seconds still to go. We're chewing that up fast. Look at that go. I know. Poor me, eh? Just a big baby. just sucks. I was saying this. Like, you ever had it where your hair hurts? Like, you run your fingers through your hair and your hair hurts? You're like, ow. Like, what the hell's going on? this is a weird one. Let alone all the rest of my goddamn body. So yes, we're all wrapped in a blanket.
Chill out. Comfy, comfy.
the worst too, because one minute I'm too, I'm like sweating in the blanket and I'm hot, and then, but then the second I take it off, I'm like, oh God, I'm cold. So it's like you just have to suffer and sweat. Oh snap! Hang on, I got food in the oven too. I just remembered. I got enough time to go grab it here. One sec. That's how you know you're sick. It's like just the temperature change from going from the main floor to the basement. I'm so sensitive right now. I was just like, oh God. As I walked down the stairs, it was just like this, like, I was going to start shivering. I'm like, oh. Back under the blanket. Pardon me too. Here I am being a shitty streamer. Let me get some proper shout out here for our girl Stationary Obsessive. Go check her out, man. Super entertaining. Always a good time over there. Whatever she's playing, it's always a good time. But man, there we go. Did I forget anybody else? Okay. Well, we just flew 350,000 light seconds for 4 high metal planets. crap, that's on. My eyes are so sensitive right now that actually hurts my eyes. Can't see. Oh my god, is this thing like right on top of the sun? Yep.
Oh my god, with the sun right behind it, it's hard to scan.
You can't see the damn thing. Stationary, have you ever played? Have you ever played Elite Dangerous? I can't. I don't think I've ever seen you play this game. It's a little bit of a heavy learning curve, but I mean, it's a pretty good game. Fun. Very relaxing. Yeah, I have kind of a routine. I'm not scanning everything because there's like a million, as I always say, this game and my dating life are very similar. Millions and millions of icy bodies out there. Cold, frigid, icy bodies. and there ain't too much time. Ain't too much point in wasting your time on those because they're not worth nothing. But I'm trying to so I'm kind of cherry picking. I'm going for the ones that I know are worth a little bit of money or just that are kind of unusual or interesting or whatever. No, I never have. What is it? Strategy, you have story. Well, it's essentially like a space flight sim. You spend a lot of your time, pretty much the whole game is spent in the cockpit of a spaceship like this, but you can also, now they've added stuff where you can get out on foot and run around and do some like first person shooter stuff as well. But it's an interesting game because it covers a lot of bases. Like, you can kind of, essentially it's a space flight sim, but you can kind of tackle the game any way you want. Here, I'll show you something interesting. So this is the map. It is an actual rendering of the actual Milky Way galaxy. All 4,400 billion stars. So there's a lot of game to explore. So exploration is a big part of the game, and there's tons of lore, like, ooh, where is the lost city of Raxla? It's the lost city of the dead aliens that used to fight the aliens that they were fighting now in the game. You know, and all this kind of stuff. And so you like Raxla. Ooh, look for the search for Raxla is like a big deal in the game. Everybody's looking for it. You know, and God knows where it is. But there's all kinds of weird stuff to find, like out in space. And you can go around space, like putting your name on stuff, like first discovered, first footfalls, first scan mapped, and all this kind of stuff. And you can make quite a bit of money that way. Plus, then everybody who plays the game sees that you were the first one who found that thing. You know what I mean? It's kind of cool. So you can write your name across the stars. But if you want, you can play, so I'm kind of outside in the exploring, but most of the game actually takes place in the bubble, which is over here. If I can get the game to actually go over there, come on. Come on. There we go. In this area over here, if I go map mode... Well, anyways, I can't figure out how to get it to work. Where's that power play thing? That shows me. Oh, there we go. Power play mode. There. So, see this little thing here? Out in the middle of that little area right there? That's where like 95% of the game is actually taking place, where almost everybody does everything. It's called the bubble. And so it's, and even in just that, like, you can spend forever in this game just flying around doing combat missions, fighting one political faction, helping one political faction fight another. This game has a huge player investment too, where like there's player groups that actually own whole systems and they fight other in-game political like they're their own political factions now in the game, because they got to be such big player groups and had such an impact on the game and stuff. Like, it's, so there's a very interesting playback back and forth between the developers and the game players. You know, game players get a lot of input into the game. It's interesting. But if you want to do space combat, you can do that. If you want to do mining, you can be like a space miner, go around, you know, you can be a space explorer, you can go fight aliens out in space, there's the Thargoids, there's a whole, but yeah, space, you can be like a transportation specialist where you do deliveries, or where you take passengers out on big sightseeing journeys all through space, and you can make your money that way. It's like a million ways you can do it, you know? And I've kind of dabbled in a bunch of different stuff, but I've kind of, the two things that, the fighting parts of it, the fighting aliens and pirates and stuff, has always been fun. I've done most of my money I've made doing that, but I also really enjoy the exploring. It's just really, I'm kind of a space nerd. I always say I'm a space nerd in the way like a stone hippie is a space nerd. I'm like, dude, space is blowing my mind. Like, I'm not like super technical. Some guys, they know all the little details and stuff, but I just find it very, it's like, you know, awe-inspiring. I don't know. And this game really kind of captures that, so. Yeah, it's fun. Plus, then you get to fly around in a spaceship. That's always fun. But it has a very steep learning curve. It's like, I spent the first probably about 30 hours playing this game, just like flying around in circles, because there's no instructions or anything. You just kind of get tossed into a spaceship and off you go. So I got blown out of the sky a few times by some gankers early in the game. I got, I had a pretty rough run early. Took about 30 hours before I, and actually what it was is I hooked up with our man Vincent Bosch. And he kind of got me on track, yeah. Yeah, it's definitely worth checking out, man. Yeah, plus Elite is. It's one of the fun, the most friendly communities on Twitch, in my opinion. Really supportive. Really supportive. Speaking of one of my, there's my other carry. I said Vincent Bosch was the first one, and then shortly behind him was Wally. I'm pretty sure it went in that order. And the two guys, those two guys, if it wasn't for those two guys, I say I wouldn't have made it anywhere in this game. Very very supportive community. It's good too. It's because it's such, it does have such a steep learning curve. If the community was like all trolly and vicious, like no one would ever play this game. You'd never get anywhere. Like, it's a big part of what gets you is because everybody's so inviting, and it's a lot of fun playing it with other people too. 5,600 hours. Oh my god, my whole fucking Steam library might not add up to that much, dude. You're an animal, Wally. But I understand, if there was ever a game that you could put that kind of hours into, man, there's guys that have been playing this game. I can't, and that's actually nothing. There's guys that are playing. That's what got me into Call of the Wild. Part of it. I didn't expect to enjoy the game as much as I did. I really wasn't thinking a hunting sim was going to be something I'd really be into. But it turned out to be tons of fun. And then on top of it, the community was so supportive and friendly and welcoming. You know what I mean? So. Yeah, and so if that's the type of thing you're looking for, you will enjoy Elite Dangerous. I think you'd have a good time. Not to try and sell you on it, nothing, but, you know. No, Elite is a really warm and inviting community, and it's very, there's gankers out there, even the gankers are kind of like the funniest, friendliest bunch of gankers I've ever seen, for the most part. And if anybody gets too out of line, the community generally just checks them pretty fast. You'll get a bunch of like anti-ganker guys if word gets out the system's getting hit too hard or guys are being pricks out there, people will literally put together little anti-gank groups and go out and take guys out and stuff. I love it. It's hilarious. So. It's fun. But you know, I got love for everybody. As our man Tony Curtis says, gankers gotta eat. Gankers gotta eat too. Okay, what am I doing? Fuck, my brain is like, there's like a massive delay in my brain between like, okay, thought, go, and then a full second before anything happens. It's like, oh man.
find Elite's a really interesting game too, because it's a very international crowd, because it's a Euro-based game company, so you have a huge UK following and a big, really big Euro following. Really, but like a lot of like Aussies play the game. You know, it's interesting, as well as quite a bit of you know, Western, North American, whatever you would call it, stuff there too. So this has a really interesting broad range of communities too. Meet a lot of people from all over the world playing this game. Exactly. I kind of have a relationship with my brain. I don't even watch Simpsons. You know, Homer like talks to his own brain, and his brain doesn't really want to work for him. It's kind of like he's his brain is not anything wrong with it, except that it's all surly and full of attitude. And that's kind of my brain too. It's like, come on, brain, get to work. God damn it, we're supposed to be on the same team. Flying like a noob here because I'm all tired. No, I'm not in the right mode, that's why. I said I relate to Homer. The other one is the space issue. They joked on The Simpsons that Homer he has a limited amount of space. So as some facts go in the front door, other facts are just getting lost out the back door. I think I have the same problem. I've already checked. I know they're going to be iron fumaroles or whatever, and I'm not interested. I've already seen those little lava vents and stuff. Anything else in this system I want to scan? I don't think so. Oh, what? Ammonia-based life. Why? It's so big, though. We flew 350,000 light seconds to get out here. We might as well. Why not? Another game too reminds me, actually, in a strange way, it kind of reminds me of Call of the Wild, in that it's a game that's really, the beauty of the game is really what gets you. You know what I mean? The game, Call of the Wild, very awe-inspiring game sometimes. And in both games, I say it's kudos to whoever did the lighting. You know, in Call of the Wild, when you're, you know, stalking animals through the bush in the misty morning and the sun comes up through the trees and it's all glit, it's like, Jesus God, they did a good job in that game. I was like, wow. And this one too, when you're driving your little planetary rover through a fucking, you know, moon crater while the sun cusps the horizon, it's like, holy man. It's like, it's pretty epic views. I've never taken those two games. I've never taken more screenshots than I have in those two games. Some games, there's no time. Like Deep Rock, I'm always under such pressure. That game, I never have time. That might not be. That ring is really small. It's the ring that makes these scanning certain plants pee in the ass. Plants with rings are always just like twice the amount of work.
But that's that itty-bitty little ring. I might be able to work right around that thing. Or is it just an enormous planet? I can't tell. Is it a little ring or a big planet? Oh god, the screenshots I've taken and done nothing but fill up too much storage with the eye, I feel you. I know. Time to feed myself and the birds. Lurky lurk. Lucky lurk. Oh, thank you. Lurky lurk. I'll take a lucky lurk or a lurky lurk. Either one. Appreciate that. Well, thanks for coming in, Stationary. It was good to see you. Let me get that ring. Goddamn. What? Still gotta fly around the damn thing. Good.
Surface scan by 50%.
Oh, the ring is bigger than it looks. So shit. How much bigger is it? Yeah, you can't even see it there, but that's in a ring. Whoa, there it is. Whoa, baby. It's oh, yeah. Okay, so it's an invisible ring. Interesting.
Yeah, it's weird, eh? It's weird how it, like, just appears and disappears. I guess it's just the lighting or something, you know? But it was just weird how it doesn't... It looks really thin, and then all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute. Why are those void opals floating out in space? That's weird. And, yeah, not... Fudge, where's the last spot here? There. But, yeah, it's way bigger than it looks. It's like... Mystery, the invisible ring. I like it. It's the one ring. It's the one ring to rule them all. I guess, it didn't go invisible. I guess it turned you invisible, didn't it? Oh, whatever. Close enough. You guys heard anything about this new Lord of the Rings show coming out? It's getting just, well, some of the guys I like that I watch for critical reviews are not too excited about it. They're really hammering on the some of the dwarves or something. They didn't do the dwarves right or something. I don't know, but I'm curious to see. I love Lord of the Rings, so I would love for there to be some good new Lord of the Rings thing to come out. That'd be dope.
there's nothing else here worth checking out, we're out of here.
We gotta be getting... Actually, I should check. What are we... Oh, we're less than 20 jumps from the little nebula we're trying to get to. Oh, yeah, I guess that's sort of... Wow, you can barely see the damn thing, though.
Frameshift drive charging.
Do you think they had a lighting issue with neutron stars and dwarfs before? I think they fixed that. Oh, okay. Gotta get back to work with something? Yeah, for sure, Wally. No worries, buddy. Appreciate you stopping in, man. I should be on tonight for my usual time, kind of, Wally, too. This is just because I couldn't sleep, mostly. I was trying. I couldn't get back to bed. It's the weird buzzing. I told you, I get this weird buzzing going on. It's really making it difficult to sleep. So, yeah. But I should still be on for my usual time tonight. I think I'm actually, to be honest with you, I'm actually starting to feel a little better. Not a ton, but I feel like I've gone over the cusp of this illness or whatever. I'm on the mend. Alright, even now I'm talking better, you know? Just a lot.
Even since yesterday, I'm way less hoarse.
It's like a whole system of crappy icy bodies. Rocky ice and icy bodies and stuff, and I didn't see anything interesting at all there. Nope, it's all... Wow, nothing. What a boring system.
Scooping.
no pretty little water world.
Don't mind if I do.
And a high metal.
First discovered by Bailey, too. Oh, geez, I wonder if this water world has already been first discovered, or but I wonder if it's been mapped. No, damn you, Balan Tillies. Bastard. No. That's alright, he didn't take that high metal, though. Coward.
Why would he not scan that?
Talk about, I thought I was bad for cherry picking. Talk about cherry picker, man. Look how easy that is. I mean, and honestly, why wouldn't you scan the whole bloody system with four fucking planets? He could have had the full system scan, and he just cherry picked that away from everybody. Dirty bastard.
surface scan by 50%.
What?
Stupid thing.
Seriously? What the hell? Okay.
Surface scan.
songs are going around in circles here.
Safe as get over now. Come on, you stupid thing. You know, I don't remember. I don't think. Do I have my camera bound to my on foot stuff? Isn't there some way to get your camera mode when you're on foot?
scoop deployed. Cargo scoop retracted.
Is it showing me the inside of the cockpit, though? How do I get outside the cockpit here? Hang on. Those buttons aren't working, though. Cockpit front. Well, how the hell? Seen this before where you can do this too. It's a whole bunch of new features to the camera thing that I don't really understand, so I'm still trying to figure them out here. Holy fucking skiing. I'm not even getting gas, I'm just flying down the hill. Like, I can't stop. Shit. I got no traction, baby. This looked like a deep drop down this hill. I was kind of, man, this really looks deep. God damn. I'm going backwards. Turn around, you stupid car. Kids, stop. That's my ship. Turn around. I can't stop this stupid thing. What the? Is that gonna? Nope. Handbrake's not helping. Nope. Handbrake's not helping. We're just sliding all the way to the bottom of the fuck. This is not what I intended to do. Ooh. We're flying in here. Ah! I don't want to blow up. Holy shit, this is the long way down. God! Oh, no! No! Come on, baby. You can do it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. On your wheels. Yes, I'm aware we're flying through the air. I'm very aware. I can't stop. Oh my god. Where are we? What's going on? I'm going backwards. Oh, this is bad. Maybe we can look. Here we go. Controlled descent. A nice controlled descent. Why can I not turn? or slow down or stop or do anything. Shit. Oh, no. Come on, we got it. Look, we're at the bottom. We got to be able to stop. Holy fucking hell. Warning, hull integrity 25. I'm can't help it. We're going to die. We're going way too fast. There's no way to stop. There's no way to fucking stop. Stop, 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 stop. Oh. Okay, are we still, oh, we're still flying through the air. Oh, no, we're going to blow up. It's going to happen, folks. There's no way around it. I don't see how we can stop it. I don't. I had no idea we were going to go fly down this thing. At like 4,000 miles an hour. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on, no! Jesus Christ. Yeah, that... I did not... I guess I should have thought that was ice. Damn it. Well, that's why we bring two SRVs. Fuck. Aw. That was painful. Well, these things happen in space, you know. What can you do? Here, I thought I was gonna go for a nice side. I was like, oh, we'll go for a little drive down the side. It looked kind of deep, but I didn't think it was like, anyways. Yeah. Oh well. These things happen. I guess I should have thought it's pure ice and this stupid thing has no traction, even on like a planet that's all dirt. So maybe I should have considered that. Oh well. It's dangerous in space, man. Oh, I don't, you know, I don't have that command. I might have, I thought I had some kind of command for stream time, but I might not. But we've been going for, we're coming up on the 3 hour mark. I'm probably not going to go too much longer here because the kid's going to get up in probably an hour or two and I should get a few things done before then. This is more of a, I said, I can't sleep stream. Yeah, and this whole system is just nothing else here. Okay, we're going to jump to the next system, and then I think we're going to call in there, folks. Maybe we'll see if we can find somebody to read. Stupid planet. I'm going to have to escape Vector. Shit, where is it? Where's the escape Vector? Oh, we got a lot of clips around here that... why can't I get away from this planet? Hang on a second, I know, dude. I did get first footfall, though. Look at that. It's not showing it to me for some reason. Okay. It's supposed to be a little thing that says like escape trajectory or something like that that you gotta line up with. But yeah. We're at 2 minutes and 48 or 2 minutes, 2 hours and 48 minutes. That little event was around the 240 mark, I think that started. It went up for quite a while. I did not expect that to happen. I just didn't realize. I mean, I guess I've noticed that you have like zero traction in those things. I just didn't think I was going to go shooting down that hill like 400 miles an hour. And there was no gravity too. It was low gravity, so every time I hit a bump, I would just go launch off. It was like, oh shit. And I was trying to manage the landings with my my jets, but I was just taking huge damage. I'm all... That's why we take two of those little SRVs. For that exact reason. Because you never know what the hell's going to happen in space. But it's good though. We're actually getting close to this. There's a little, this little nebula right here is where we're headed. The NGC 281 nebula. And we're not too far out. I like it. Okay, one last jump, and then we're gonna find somebody to read here. Frameshift drive charging. And I should be back on for my usual time tonight, folks. Oh, this was sort of a little weird one. But yeah, I think I'm already starting to feel, even since I started the stream, I'm feeling a little better. These antibiotics usually kick in pretty quick. That's been my experience.
You feel like garbage, then you take your antibiotics, and within a day or two, you start feeling quite a bit better.
That's part of the trick. That's why they always hammer you to make sure you keep taking. They always want you to finish them, take them all, or whatever, right? And that's why people don't. It's because they take them for a couple days and they start to feel better. So. Man, that was dumb. I was just like, damn it. I wanted to go. I was gonna go explore, and like there was some stuff on that planet to look for, and I was just like, ah, I lost my enthusiasm to go look for it after I got killed. All right, folks. I think we're gonna call her there. Let's we'll find someone else to pass you off to who's playing this game. It's there's a really enormous and very friendly community around this game on Twitch here, and lots of good people you can network with and stuff. It's really cool. Boop. Oops. I'm sorry. I just realized I got fucking Simpsons playing in the background here. That wasn't cool. Going through the mic for you guys too much. Okay, let's see who's around. But yeah, I appreciate you guys coming out. It's for sort of a weird stream for me, kind of off schedule, so surprised anybody showed up at all, but appreciate you guys. Always more fun when we go do stuff together. I don't know, Twitch has been rough lately, too, with the hosts and raids and stuff. I know mine haven't been working, and same with other people. Oh, yeah, okay, I know who we're going to get. All right, folks, make sure you drop those raid emotes. And drop those follows when you get in here. Really, really fun, friendly person. Again, good example of how friendly the Elite Dangerous community is. We are going to go raid Friendship Drive Charging. If I can find her in the list here. Come on. Spell this because I can't spell. There. Alright. Take care, everybody. We'll see you guys again later. Peace.
just spinning around bounty hunting in a Fair de Lance again this afternoon. Stationary, obsessive, welcome in. Gplay 69 raid. Welcome, welcome. And thank you for the follow as well, Stationary Obsessive. Right, we're just hunting for pirates here. Usually, you know, we have like periods of downtime where, you know, there's pirates and then there's no pirates for a bit. This guy's a pirate and he's a Diamondback Explorer. Get in. Somebody else has already opened fire, look. Let's go. Kill, kill, kill. Ducking and weaving.